From the very beginning of Buddhist traditions, breathing is a very important point of meditation practice. In some traditions, they count the breath or they watch the breath. But in Dogen Zenji tradition, we don't count breaths, we don't watch breaths. Some people, even in Soto Zen tradition, they encourage their student. But at least in my lineage, Sakiroshi Uchemura's lineage, we don't watch breaths, we don't count breaths. We breathe as naturally as possible. But still, it's important to breathe abdominally. That means we breathe through our nose as if the air goes down to the abdomen. During Zazen or meditation, we make sure, you know, when we are breathing, the stomach is moving. This is important to have a deep breath. That means air goes in our body. My teacher said this is important. Attention is always here, but it should go down here. My teacher says, you know, sometimes or often meditation practice in Buddhism is a practice of concentration. We pay attention to one object to concentrate in order not to think or enter the world of thinking. But in our tradition, or just sitting, we don't even do that. That means there's no one object to concentration, for concentration. But Uchamro said our practice of just sitting is like driving a car. When we are driving a car and we pay one particular object, then it's dangerous. But when we drive a car, our mind should be everywhere, not only something in the car or something outside the car. But our mind is nowhere, therefore our mind can be everywhere. So something happened inside or outside, we can adjust. So that is awareness or awakening in our practice. Even when we sit in this way, you know, our brain is still working. You know, our stomach is working and our heart is working. There's no reason, only our brain stop working. And the function of our brain is produce thought. So in our Zazen, thoughts are coming and going, and our practice is not stop that. When those thoughts coming and going became object of this person sitting, then our mind is separated into two parts. The thoughts that become object, and this person is thinking about this thought. This thought become object. And sometimes I like this idea, or I hate that idea, or I become angry about some memory. If we do such a thing, you know, our mind is separated in two parts, subject and object. That is a problem. So that is what we call thinking. So when we find we are thinking, that means there's a separation between within our mind, subject and object, we stop that. That is what let go of thought means, or in my teacher's expression, opening the hand of thought. Thought are just coming and going, that is a natural function of our brain. But when we grasp it, then we are thinking. I'm thinking about this thought, whether it's right or wrong, or good or bad. I found I do this, then there are two sides. And when we found it, we open our hand and return to just sitting, means deep breath and upright posture, and keep our eyes open. That means not sleep. When we are sleepy, we are dream. We in this quiet condition, sleeping and awakening is not so clear. Often I think I'm waking, but somehow in my mind I'm dreaming, and I think I'm thinking. But that is very difficult condition. But whenever I found I'm sleeping or dreaming, I wake up to the soul, you know, make sure my eyes are open without seeing anything. So this upright posture, deep breath, and not sleeping, and letting go of thought. Those are the four points we return. But often we deviate from those four points. This is just sitting. But when we found we deviate from, you know, just sitting, we return to just sitting. That means posture, breathing, not sleeping, and letting go. That is what we do in our meditation practice. So actually, this is not really meditation. Thoughts are coming and going, but we don't think. So our business in sitting facing the wall is keep returning to this posture, breathing, not sleeping, and letting go. Yes. And this cannot be done with our thinking. Stop thinking is another kind of thinking. So we don't even think not to stop, not thinking. But my teacher said, this is done with our body, not with our mind. About his Dazen, Dogen, the founder of Soto Zen tradition, called dropping off body and mind. Dropping off body and mind. That means we sit this body and this mind, but mind is empty. We don't try not to do anything with our mind. But so in our practice, body is really important. Keep this upright posture and returning to this posture and breathing. So mainly, the Zen means sitting meditation. But Dogen often called this practice as sitting instead of meditation. For him, just sitting is dropping off. Dropping off means when we grasp, it sticks. But when we open our hand, it drops off. That means we become free from our clinging to our body and mind. Then this body and mind is only five skandhas, only collection of five skandhas. And that is the time when we are free from this clinging, when we open our hand. Then we see as a subject, but we become one with all beings. You know, things are coming and going, like air is coming and coming in and going out. And if there is some sound coming and going. So nothing stays here. So these five skandhas really become emptiness. So our practice is not contemplating about emptiness as an object, but we become empty. Five skandhas being five skandhas that are empty. That is our practice. That's why we cannot make sure, you know, I attain that condition or stage. When we evaluate what is doing, then again there's a separation between subject and object. So our practice is without any evaluation or judgment. So that is another meaning of just sitting.